Hello and welcome to this look at the Pixel Chooser in Boris Continuum with me, Ben Brownlee from Boris FX. Now the Pixel Chooser is a defining feature of the Continuum filters. So let's have a look at how we can use them to define or limit where we apply our effects in creative and interesting ways. Pixel Chooser is probably one of the most useful and powerful features available in Boris Continuum. It's a way of choosing or limiting where certain effects are applied to. Now, for some filters, such as Beauty Studio, this is built directly into the effect. But for other effects, we can choose whether to use this or not. So let's come over and take a look at our first clip. And I want to do a bit of quick color correction on this one. So I could use some of the color and tones here, but I want to just maybe stylize this up a little bit more. So I'm going to come straight into my film style and use my two-strip color as a filler over the top. And let's pop into our effects controls, come into the effects browser, and find something that works for us. I'm going to look for something that's really going to boost up what's happening within the fire scene and give us an interesting stylized look, which is, you know, vivid amber skin. It's very vivid. It's very amber. Happy with that. Hit apply. And I can use my mix with original just to dip it down a little bit. Now, my mix with original obviously affects the filter over the entire image, so it's toning everything down. What if I just wanted to isolate this area around here instead? Well, I can do that easily with Pixel Chooser Mocha. And by default on this filter, we have the Pixel Chooser turned off. So I'm going to turn this on. And now we have a few more drop downs available to us. We have Pixel Chooser as a mask. So we can look at some basic shapes such as egg, oval, rectangle, which we'll obviously look at in a moment, or we can have it as a matte. So we can choose either the luminance matte or one of the color channels, or even pull a key on our footage. I'm going to have a look at one of the color channels. And at the moment, I can't see what's happening. So I'm going to come into my Pixel Chooser and go view mask matte. And now we get a black and white image of the matte. And here I have another few drop downs of what matte type I want. And once you've used them a few times, you'll find which one is most suitable for your footage. In this case, I can see that levels is going to be much better for me. So I can come in, I can adjust things like the black level, and I can change the white level here. So now wherever anything is white, it's going to be completely affected by the effect. Wherever anything is pure black, it's not going to be affected by the effect. And where anything is grey, it's going to be more or less affected, depending on how light or dark it is. You can even do things like add in a big choke or a negative choke, and blur this up as well. So we're really playing up on the skin tone areas around here. So now if I turn off my view matte mask and use the bypass up at the top to see a before and after, I'm actually very happy with where things are around the campfire. What I'm not happy about, and maybe it's probably going to be easier if I use compare at this point, what I'm not happy about is how much it's affecting the sky. So we want to limit this effect even more. So come back down to the Pixel Chooser, view our mask and matte one more time. And even though we have a Pixel Chooser matte already selected, come into my mask and choose my shape, and I can add in a shape on top of that. And if we have our HUD widgets turned on, I can even use the widget effect to decide where that center point is. Now, of course, it looks like it's off center, but that's only because we have the compare turned on. If I turn my compare off, or maybe instead of the circle, I have an oval, and I can change that up either on the viewer itself or coming in and using the sliders over on this side. And of course, I can feather all of this up as well. There we go. So now if I turn off my view matte mask, turn on my compare one more time, side by side, and maybe turn off the widget so we don't get confused what's happening, I can see the effect is now being limited even more down to this area here. And at this point, if I need to, I can just make the last small manual adjustments. Now, just as we can save out presets for the effect itself, I could also load and save presets for the Pixel Chooser. So if I save this preset here, and I'll find a suitable bin, and I'll call this one Fireside Oval, hit OK on that. If I add in another effect now, maybe a fun favorite like a fast film process, let's pop into the effect on that, find a good one here, maybe a Hollywood day for night, which makes the sky a lot moodier, but also means we can't see any of our people down here. So it's at this point where I can turn on my Pixel Chooser on the fast film process, come to my presets, and either choose one of the default presets, or I can load in my fireside oval here, come to my Pixel Chooser mask, hit invert, and now I'm only affecting the stuff outside of the fire pit. Actually, I think that looks even better with the Pixel Chooser mat not inverted, and I can make some small adjustments here as I need to. And when I'm happy with that, let's do the compare again, and I'll compare it to my original layer here, and let's play that back. Now, some effects, such as BCC Beauty Studio, have Pixel Chooser activated from the very first. So we have a little look here. We can see that Pixel Chooser is being used to try and make a rough key on our skin. Sometimes it doesn't hit it completely, so what we can do is come into the Pixel Chooser straight away and maybe choose a couple of different samples of the skin here. And that's given us a bit more of a convincing mask for this skin. I can, of course, still come in and do the usual stuff, such as changing my black and white clipping so that I can pull the best key that I can. And that's not looking too bad. And then once I've done that, I'll then come in and adjust the rest of my controls here. We don't want this too smooth. There's a lot of this clip that goes out of focus anyway, so adding too much smoothness is going to be a little bit of a detriment. Now, if I add a bit of color correction as well, and remember to use the mask, you can start to see, if I bring the brightness up and the saturation down just a bit, don't get it too harsh, you can start to see, if I play this back, that we have a bit of buzzing in the sides here. And that's because our key isn't perfect. So what I really want to do is try and isolate the face out instead of having the face plus all the other stuff that I have affected by the key. This is really easy because we have a version of Boris Mocha built directly into the Pixel Chooser. So if I launch my Mocha mask, and I'm happy with doing proxy tracking here to speed things up, what I can do with this is make a quick shape around my face. And I'll call this one face track. And I'm just going to track this through. And because Mocha's playing the tracker, it's going to easily be able to deal with this track, even though hair's moving around. She also smiles in the picture as well. You know, all these sort of things that would normally throw a point tracker off, Boris's Mocha is able to just chew through this really easily. And once I've tracked this through in both directions, I can make any sort of small changes that I need to. I didn't expect any big problems with the track, and I didn't get them. And at this stage, I can even add in other shapes, so maybe a shape for the lips as well. So we don't want lips or eyes being affected in the same way as the skin. And I can easily link this one to the face track, so we don't have to do the work twice. All I have to do is quickly go through and maybe just adjust up the shape so that it compensates for when she starts smiling. I'll just tell it to subtract the lips from the overall mask, and I can then exit out of here. And as if by magic, if we view our mask now, we're now completely isolating out the face. And just as we could do with any other mask, I can come in and just feather this up so we don't have quite as harsh a transition. Now I can look back in here and make any other adjustments that I need to. Probably don't want to take the saturation quite as far down, or take the brightness quite as far up. Then again, let's take a look at the compare side by side. We can get full and detailed matte and mask control within the Pixel Chooser to really isolate out the areas that we want to affect. And that even includes things like gradients, which we haven't looked at, as well as the symbol shapes and the Mocha shapes. And that's just a quick look at what we can do with Continuum's Pixel Chooser in Avid Media Composer. If you found this video useful, then remember to hit the like button. For more ways to master Boris Continuum in Avid, subscribe to the Boris FX YouTube channel and check out our other tutorials. If we're missing something, then let me know in the comments below. My name's Ben Brownlee from Boris FX, and thanks for watching.